Hello everyone, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. We thank you so much for tuning in this week. Last week we talked about calibration frames and how they can improve your astrophotos immensely. This week we're going to talk about the number one thing that you can do to improve your astrophotos. You may have heard it before, you may need to hear it, but we're going to tell you again, you need to collect more data. Integrate and stack more data so we can, one, improve our signals to noise ratio. Every image has unwanted noise and desired signal. By stacking more and more frames, you decrease that unwanted noise and you increase that desired signal. Secondly, you can take that stacked image, put it into software, and you can more aggressively stretch your histograms or your curves so that you can really bring out those details without clipping your darks or your lights. So sometimes when I reflect and I think back about 6 years or so ago when I started doing astrophotography, I know that I wanted to increase the quality of my astrophotos just as fast as I possibly could. Now, we do understand that when you first get started, how exciting it is. I felt the same way. We all here at High Point Scientific felt the same way about our first image. You know, it's new, you want to go outside, you want to take as many photos as you possibly can of as many targets. You may want to spend like 30 minutes on Andromeda and 25 minutes on Orion and then 30 minutes on the Whirlpool Galaxy, and this is perfectly fine. It's exciting, it's new. You're just trying to see what you're actually capable of capturing, and that is awesome. If you enjoy this, we 100% recommend doing this. There may come a point where you say, you know what, I think I want to improve the quality of my astrophotos. 30 minutes, 25 minutes, 1 hour typically isn't gonna cut it. Here's just one example of why it's so important to capture data, especially in a light polluted area. This image over here on the left, you have 1 hour of integration time in Bortle 7, and over here, you have 16 total hours of integration time. You may not be able to tell the difference right off the bat, but if you stretch the data, it's where you can really see the difference here. The nebulosity over here on the right image is much more prevalent than it is here on the left image, and the noise is not even comparable. To put it concisely, you need more data. You need more exposure time. You need to spend more time on a single target. Rather than spending one night on three or four separate targets, spend three or four nights on one target. When we say you need to collect more data, we do take into consideration that you may not have clear skies all the time. You may be able to grab maybe an hour or 2 hours between clouds once, maybe twice a week if you're lucky. We totally get that, but that doesn't change the fact that you need more exposure time if you want to improve the quality of your astrophotos. Now, 5 hours, 7 hours, even 15 or 20 hours may seem like a lot, but if your goal is top-notch photos, top-notch data, clean, crisp, noiseless data, you need to spend that time. You need to go out every night you can and work towards gathering as much data as you can on one single target. Here we have the Hamburger Galaxy shot in Bortle 3 skies. On the left side, you have 1 hour of integration. In the middle, you have 5 hours. And on the right-hand side, you have 15 hours of integration. You can really start to tell a difference when you zoom in. At a 2-to-1 ratio, you can tell that the noise comparison is not even close. The one on the left-hand side has significantly more noise, while the one on the right-hand side has barely any noise whatsoever. Many of us here, including myself, such as Kyle and Dave and Matt and Patrick, we all experience these cloudy nights and these weather droughts and we can't collect any data, and sometimes we have to resume a project that we started a month ago or even 3 weeks ago, and it takes us a whole entire month or a month and a half to collect the amount of data that we want to collect, because we know if we go out in a single night, 3 hours of data just simply isn't going to cut it, especially if you're shooting a dim galaxy or a dim nebula. Again, we know we need that 15 or those 30 hours of total data, and it's gonna take a month, but it takes patience and it takes persistence and it takes the experience to know that you need to shoot more than 3 or 4 hours of data. You need to go out every night that you can set up and go out and set up and just grab those photons and just stick to that one single target, and it will be worth your while. All right, well, that is it for this video. We thank you so much for tuning in. If you liked the video, be sure to like the video. Subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any of our future content. Click that notifications button so you know when we upload our next video. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments below, or feel free to visit us at highpointscientific.com, and our non-commissioned product advisors will be more than happy to help you with any of your questions. Thank you so much, and clear skies.